Welcome to Birmingham, Alabama and Samford University, the site of the 2017 Gulf South Conference Basketball Championship.
And welcome live inside the Pete Hanna Center here in Birmingham, Alabama. Florida Space Coast presents the championship game of the 2017 Gulf South Conference Men's Basketball Championship. Hello, everyone. Glad to have you along. It's my privilege to be with Coach Bill Jones today. And, Coach, we're going to have a terrific game because you know about the Gulf South Conference. Should be a great matchup today.
I do, and I know about the rivalries in this league. And today, we got the two high-scoring teams in the league, and we got two competitors, and I'm telling you, it's going to be an exciting day in Pete Hanna today because these teams, we put up new nets after that last women's game here, and I guarantee you they're going to be burned off at halftime.
You know, there was a little bit of work to get here by these teams. It just didn't happen during the regular season. If you're a higher seed or a lower seed, you get to host the game. Alabama Huntsville got the win over Union. Then they defeated Delta State last night. Valdosta State over UNA in a high-scoring game, and then a 10-point win over CBU by 10 points. One of the things that you know, Bill, you coach, if you don't have good players, you're not a good coach, right? And we have two of the best in the GSC. And let's begin with the young man that's done a great job for Valdosta State.
I learned really early I've had great players. I was an okay coach. Look at Jeremiah Hill here from Valdosta State, 6'2", from Savannah, transfer from Savannah State. He's third in the league in scoring at 19.8 points a game. GSC Player of the Year, he's one of those guys. When he gets off the bus, you better know where he is. He's going to score. The other one from UAH, Steve Webster. Steve Webster is a local guy from Gurley right outside of Huntsville, 6'6". Been a tremendous player for UAH over the years, 18 points a game. He's fifth in scoring in the league. He's an All-South District player, first-team GSC. Boy, we got two matchups tonight with those players, but we got matchups all the way down through the ranks with these two teams.
Yeah, one thing about it this year, Bill, is you look at any Lenny Acuff, and, you know, as a former coach, you appreciate good coaching, and Lenny's been about as good as there's been for 20 years in this league.
Well, he's been the coach of the year eight times. I mean, you don't do that just by sitting around waiting on something to happen. Lenny does a terrific job with the players that he's got. He coaches them from the ground up. He's a terrific guy. He's a role model, and role models in athletics sometimes are hard to find, and there's one right there on camera in Lenny Acuff.
No doubt about it, and he has, again, one of his great teams, but he has a good coach at the other end, too. When you talk about Mike Helfer, he's in his 12th year. He was the coach of the year, and he probably has, when we're talking about Coach Helfer of Valdosta State, the best team he's had probably in his career there.
And he'll tell you that too. He's combined a bunch of transfers along with some JUCO kids that have got some experience. He's got senior-laden roster, which UAH has also got. He's Coach of the Year this year in the GSC, third time for him. He's got a pedigree of wins up and down the ranks. Two great coaches, two very athletic teams, and great matchups, even down to who's going to guard Hill and who's going to guard Webster.
Well, we'll take a break, and we'll have the opening tip for the title of the GSC Championship game for the men. Alabama Huntsville, Valdosta State, it's coming up next. Hey, no problem, man. I try to listen. You all listen to us, so. All good.
We got a lot more words than that.
Yeah. I want to get paid by the word one day.
Yeah, that's right.
We'll be good.
I will do some joke telling when that happens.
Hey. I used to have Sonny Smith in our league when Louisville and them were all in the same league.
He filled you up then. Sonny and I go way back.
Oh, I know. He said one once, he said, you know, I didn't know toilet water. Well, Alabama Huntsville, not too far away from our home site here in Birmingham. They're going to bring a lot of folks. They did last night. And, Coach, we're going to have a great one. They shouldn't have brought my drawers out here today. What's going on?
Look at those characters that came up here. I don't know which team they're for yet, but we'll find out in just a minute, I'm sure.
I think they're on full scholarship in something. I'm not sure what.
Yeah, well, I really like their dress. It may get a little hot in that when this ball starts flying up down the floor, but I like what they wore.
We should have a great championship game. Alabama, Huntsville, and Valdosta State. And Valdosta in the gray home uniforms. And, of course, UAH. And the lower seed blue.
Well, you see some matchups already. We got Gilmore starting on Jeremiah Hill. It's going to be interesting. Coach Acuff thinks that Gilmore may be the best defensive player in the league, and we'll see.
Yep. Justin Simon, 6'6 senior, gets off to a good start for VSU as they have the first 2 points in the game. There's Webster trying to take it inside and knocked away. And here comes Roberts up quickly. Hill let it go and didn't get any of it. Saved in, but it ends up in the hands of Sexton, who runs the show. Webster a little bit too tall.
Boy, that's what we talked about earlier. I'm telling you, we got transition basketball. And we got 3-point shots going up by both teams. And both shoot them well.
And play some good defense, as you saw right there. There's going to be a blocking foul. As Brandon Roberts took it to the basket.
And Brandon Roberts, for me, with this building, he's a transfer from Samford. 2 years down here, played a good bit down here. He's up in around Decatur, Alabama, and West Morgan High School. Good player, really good offensive player, good transition player, good free throw shooter.
Yep.
Didn't want to jinx him, but he's at 80% from a free throw line and got a nice rotation. You can see where he can shoot the ball in and out. He's about 48% from the three-point line. Got that real good quickness.
It's all about the good shooters, and he ties the game at 2.
I don't believe he hit the rim there. UAH comes out with his 30-second clock going to a little delay. 1-2-2 zone, just a passive zone, try to eat up that clock.
And it's a good setup. It's kind of that 2-3, as Bill said. And Lemons.
Gone to a 2-3, but I tell you, you better find out where Hill is.
Deep in the corner, that 3. A little bit too strong by Justice. And here comes Sexton. Gilmore, that's his first miss in the tournament.
Yes, sir.
Here in Birmingham, he was perfect last night. Lemons knocks it down.
Nice shot by Lemons. Yep. I mean, one thing we've got is great perimeter play out here today. There's some guys that can really shoot the ball.
5-2 VSU. Little back door deflected, and on the held ball. Even a held ball is going to be tough tonight.
You can see the intensity on the faces. Well, this is a automatic trip to go right here. There's a lot on the line, and Gulf South Conference has got a history of great teams going away from here, so you know this is a big one.
Gilmore trying to get it in, and finally does to Roberts. Here's Sexton. Good head fake. Webster in the corner. 3-ball is off the mark by Gilmore. Sexton had it. Guess who took it away? Hill.
Head down the middle of the floor. Finds a teammate for another transition 3.
How about that?
I'm telling you, to start the basketball game, Bo Justice hitting one from the corner. Now he's got to defend.
Yep. And Webster can't get it to go, and he's mad at himself because he won't have a chance at a 3-point play.
And when he got the lineup, he's got that big, strong body going to the basket against a smaller player. He should have converted that, and he knew it. But he's also a good free throw shooter, so he's not a guy that you can foul. He's 81% from the line himself.
That's not too shabby, is it?
Across the board, these are two good free throw shooting teams, so I don't think that's going to be putting anybody at a disadvantage when you put them to the line.
And Seed got in foul trouble last night and is limited it somewhat on his minutes. And that's where Gilmore stepped in and really helped out the Chargers.
Well, we said Valdosta sitting at 89 points a game, so UAH comes out after a made or missed free throw, and they're running that little 1-2-2 zone to try to cut that clock down to 20.
There you say, quick hands by Kip Owens to knock that away. Both of these teams will take it away in a heartbeat, won't they?
Yeah, I'm telling you, both of them are quick hands, good feet on the perimeter. D2 is generally a league of 6'7" and under players that have got that great athletic ability, and that's what we've got here.
Simon misses for VSU, and now the Charger possession. Roberts gets the opening, tries to put it in. Great defense.
Tough little basket go down the middle on that possession, but well, Valdosta will bring it at you in a hurry. Nice interior pass by Hill.
And a three-point play opportunity.
And a chance. Yep. I think it's interesting. We've gone about 4 minutes, and nobody, neither coach has even thought about substituting a player yet. They're going to go with who's got them here. You can see the interior pass down low results in the basket for Simon. Now he's at the free throw line. He's about 65%, which is pretty good, but it's low on this team.
Yep. And we used to call that a Maggie's drawers.
Ed found the range.
If you were in the military, when you missed the range, they used to wag the flag.
Right.
They called it Maggie's drawers.
Yeah. Well, he's a better shooter than that.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure right now that ball weighs about 20 pounds, though, when you get to that line.
Yeah, it does.
The offense by UAH with that backdoor cut gets Webster down on that low block where he's really effective. You can see why, too. He's got a lot of shots. He called him for a foul on that. But, you know, this is one of those games where I think in championship play the officials go out and just say, hey, let's let the players determine this instead of a lot of whistles. And we've seen that on two possessions here already.
Lemons over to Simon. Back to Lemons. Pulls the trigger. Nope. Owens the rebound, and the Chargers want to run if they have it. Webster looking for the basket.
Oh, boy. He has a really big game today. It's going to cost over Valdosta. He's in and out today. Like you mentioned, he got in foul trouble in the last one. If he stays away from foul trouble and this is the way he scores, he'll cause some trouble for Valdosta's big guys.
Yeah, he will. Speaking of big guys, Muhammad can't get it to go. And here come the Chargers into the front court. Boy, they moved the ball so well. Here's Webster again. Kick out, Gilmore. Nope.
Well, penetration drive by Webster, though, and that kick out gives a lot of opportunities out there. Sure, he'd like to have that shot back again, but he's wide open.
Yep. Bo Justice had it momentarily, and now Josh Lemon. Lemon's had 17 points, 4 rebounds, and 7 assists last night.
Oh, yeah, he's got a nice shot himself outside. Good quickness, tip away there. Hill goes back. Haven't seen him get involved in the offense yet. Struggling a little bit trying to push things.
Well, got a little help from his friends there after the miss. Yeah, he's going to tell you it's a pass.
He hadn't let the game catch up with him yet. When the game catches up to him and gets his speed, we'll see the real Hill. 28 points in 2 games already in this tournament, 28 each.
4-point lead for VSU. Webster, 3 ball off the mark. And here comes Justice bringing it up for the Blazers.
Justice averaging about 15 points a game. Strong kid. Nice interior pass again.
Oh, how good was that? We'll take a break. 14-28 remaining. First half, 12-8. Valdosta State leads UAH. Back to the Speed Anderson after this. Bill, I didn't tell you, but we have to do that dance at halftime. I may need a little practice.
I guarantee you I can do that. I can't do it with that kind of pizzazz, but I can do it. It's a lot slower than that, though.
We'll give it an effort, won't we?
That's right.
What do you think so far?
Well, I tell you, a couple of things jump out at me. One of these points in the paint, you know, the ball's going interior for Valdosta a little bit more than it is for UAH. UAH settling for the three a little bit too much right now. I'm sure in that timeout, Coach Acuff mentioned that some, because you can't give away too many interior points in the paint basket to anybody and win. So I think look for UAH this time to run a little bit more of a slow down pattern. Intensity's great. Adrenaline's running. They took a couple of shots too quick, I think, for UAH. So we'll see them settle down a little bit more in this particular series right here.
You saw Kip Owens with a towel over his head. That's because he picked up his second quick foul.
Yeah.
He had to go out.
And that's their big guy, 6'9 guy, mm-hmm. that gives them a little bit of rim protection down there. So, you know, they come to the floor with Justin Wargo, 6'6 guy from a local school, also at Buckhorn up close to Huntsville. Big, strong kid. Maybe he can give them some interior strength.
They had 12 last night. He helped out.
And you see Webster going down with a little low post blocker, which I'm sure that was called as a timeout by Coach Acuff. Let's not settle for what we've been taking. Let's get something a little bit lower. He has an opportunity to convert that. Plus, he gets a foul call, too. So fouls are going to be big as we go through, see who gets them.
Sheba, three-time All-GSC performer. First team, of course, again this year. 10 points, 8 rebounds, 5 assists, even though he played less than half the game in the win last night.
He's an impact player because he's so versatile mm-hmm. for a 6'6 guy. He can go to the glass, he can post up, he can shoot the three, puts the ball on the floor. He's a tough matchup for most people at the post position.
Hill gets it out straight away, Justice. Nice feed inside for the jam job. Carlos Beverly, great assist.
I'm going to tell you, that's a great pass by Bo Justice. That's the second one he's made as Brandon Roberts takes one out of the corner.
And a follow-up.
There's the follow-up by Justin Ward, who just came off the bench. Get on the glass, Justin Ward. I'm sure that was told to him 1,000 times.
Yep.
Bo taking a little bit of a long-range jumper.
Yep. .16-12 our score.
Look at this pass. Interior pass finds him, and he seals the guy off. Great jumping ability, quick legs. He's right up around the basket. We give half of that basket to the interior passing of Bo Justice.
You'd be in danger if you're under the hoop on that basket.
Yeah. He'd dunk you, too.
Hey, yes, he did. Oh, nice dribble drive by Chase Elliott, redshirt junior. He comes in, and he contributed last night, too.
Yeah, from Cold Springs, Alabama. I like the sound of that town. I'd like to live in Cold Springs, Alabama. He comes right off the bench and gets the thing you want out of a player off the bench. Give me a layup.
Yep. One miss. Offensive rebound. Yes, and a foul.
Well, at the last break, they had three offensive boards, and they've added to that since we started back plays from the timeout. That's a terrific inside play.
Yep.
Webster's showing a little fatigue there. He's having to jump and rebound hard against these. These guys are not only big and strong, but they're quick jumpers. They get off their feet really well around that basket. Carlos Beverly, 6'7", out of Valdosta. Went to Albany Tech, transferred back to Valdosta, and shows why he got some strength around that basket.
Yeah, he does. 19-14, Valdosta State, and we have a whistle. VSU has Jimmy Codette in. He's a junior from Williamston, Michigan. That takes us out of Alabama after that, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, Lansing junior college player. You see a lot of transfers and JUCO players on Valdosta's team. That's why they have the experience that they've got to get to this level. You got to have players, and UAH has got four seniors at start, so both these clubs have got guys that have been there before.
Yep, Justin Ward missed it. And quickly into the front court.
One thing you said about Valdosta, they run and they run hard, but they will make that interior pass to their post guys. If they work to get open, they're going to get them the ball from the perimeter.
And that's where they probably have an advantage, too.
Yeah, I think they recognize that as an advantage, so they're taking the ball in. And now a nice outside shot, but a guy just came in the ball game.
Yeah, he wasn't cold.
No, Codette, you don't want a three out of a guy when he's just in, but he took it and made it, and now he's boarding the ball.
Yeah, about that. He wants to stay on the floor, contributing right away.
Oh, that's too many.
He did the Watushi there.
Yeah, he doesn't think he did, but he did. That's about five steps.
11:54 remaining first half. It's 22-14 Valdosta State over UAH. Glad you joined us today in the Gulf South Conference.
We are explorers, pioneers, leaders. We are makers, visionaries, problem solvers. We are passionate, transformative. We are chargers. Expand your horizons at UAH.
Let's go!
GSC TV on ESPN3 is brought to you by Florida Space Coast, Orlando's closest beaches. By the Gulf South Conference, compete, impact, graduate. By Raymond James, official financial planner of the Gulf South Conference. And by NeverThirst, life flows.
And you're looking at a beautiful shot of the campus of Samford University. Glad to be in Birmingham, our backdrop today. Don Russell along with Bill Jones. Glad you joined us today on ESPN3 for the GSC Championship game.
Well, Valdosta right now kind of controlling things, most of it with their inside play. UAH is not shooting a very good percentage up until this point. They're about 29% from the floor, but I think a lot of that's because of shot selection primarily, and pretty good defense by Valdosta Duke covering the shooters.
Foul is called on Damian. Excuse me. It's going to be called on Simula.
You know, the thing that's really kind of surprising at this point, and I think it'll change, is Jeremiah Hill, our introductory play, one of the player, two players we highlighted, has not scored, and they've got a 7-point lead.
He had 28 points, 11 rebounds, 5 assists last night. And I think he mopped the floor, too.
That's a do-it-all game right there. Served popcorn, wiped the floor and everything, plus 28 points and 11 boards and 4 assists. That's about all you can do.
Yep. 22-15. Valdosta State leading UAH. Here's Hill back on the floor. Gets a high pick. Little step back three off the mark. Great rebound that time by Elliott to go in and get it.
And a good job by Chase Elliott. He's come in for Gilmore and taking the job of Hill. Transition Hill. Nice pass.
How
nice
was that?
Pass.
Very unselfish by Hill.
I'm telling you, that's the thing that Coach told me before the game, Coach Elliott. If you watch him real close, the thing he does is share the ball.
Yeah.
He doesn't shoot it all the time. He shares it all the time.
And that's not always the case with big scorers
no,
either.
No, most of the time it's not. It's usually set me a screen. Let me put it up there.
Codette goes up with the left hand, getting lost his balance. And here come the Blazers. Hill, deep corner, got it.
Just a matter of time. And I'm sure Coach Acuff's not happy with the shot taken on the end by Elliott. It's kind of a fall away layup of sorts going out of bounds. And transition now gets him to the other end. Hill, boy, nice jumper from the corner. Nice shot, nice range. You can see why he can score.
Yep. And that's the biggest lead in the game for Valdosta State. And they're looking for a double dip. The Valdosta State women upset the top seed West Florida. You were here. That might have been the best first half of women's basketball I've seen all year.
It was really good. Both teams played well. It's a shame that the girl from West Florida had to go down with a turned ankle, and felt sorry for her because she was trying her best. She put her shoe back on about four times and wanted to come back in that game. They wouldn't let her.
Well, I know you're a social media guy, but fans, you can follow the Gulf South Conference on Twitter and Facebook. Visit twitter.com/GulfSouth to begin receiving updates. And on Facebook, the account goes to visit the Gulf South Conference /GSC.
Well, you see Saxon back in the game for Chase Elliott. Give him a little stability there. Malik Cook-Stroke comes in the game for UAH.
And Ward does a good job of getting that basket. They were in a little drought there.
Well, they needed the basket. Need something to break it. That's what the timeout's for. Let's get back to what we do best instead of what we're doing.
Back door. What great body control.
And look at Hill. I mean, he goes to the basket on a backdoor cut. You don't see a lot of superstars doing backdoor cuts either. They're always wanting to come off the pick.
Yep.
Hill with the ball again. Down the middle of the floor. Good transition.
Oh, and that one slapped right back in his face by Malik Cook-Stroop. He's from right here in Homewood.
He wants that call going to the other end, too. Don't ask too many times, though. You won't get the next one.
That's right.
UAH in need of a basket
here.
They need a good run offense with some backdoor stuff and maybe something on the low block, even though they've only got Webster posting up down there right now.
And look, they're shading on him, too. Sexton.
That's a big basket
Boy,
by Sexton.
Boy, is he the glue.
That's a big basket. He's 44% from out there, but he didn't look shoot that three that much, but he found himself open that time and drained it.
He's a Cosana Academic All-American out of Louisville Trinity High School.
I'm glad to know an Academic All-American. Glad you mentioned that.
Tough inside. Shot by Muhammad. And let's see if the Chargers get on a little run here. Down by nine. Webster.
Four out, one in. Post offense screen by Webster because he can give you versatility out there.
Ten on the shot clock. And we have a whistle underneath. Somebody was holding on to Sexton, and I believe it was Justice.
Yeah, Bo Justice. Bo, he's played well, though. Justice has done a really good job up to this point for Valdosta. You see Chris Heffer there. Here's that last three, a kick out, good square up, nice release. See that rotation on the ball? That's deadly right there. Sexton got a nice shot. See why he's 44% from the line.
Yep.
I mean, from the three-point line. He's also 79% from where he is right now. And they need these points. They can cut this thing down.
And there's one of them right there.
Boy, we got two good free throw shooting teams. They both go to the line. We had one missed rim down here on the other end, but that's very unusual.
And Sexton perfect again.
Good shot. They've cut this thing to seven.
8:35 remaining in the first half. For the GSC championship on the men's side, Valdosta State won the women's title, upending West Florida, and Sexton wanted to get the steal and ended up getting a piece of Jimmy Codette.
I like Codette coming off the bench. He's aggressive offensively. He's running off screens. He's got that shot ready off most of the time when he comes off. Big kid at 6'7" out of Lansing Junior College up in Michigan, and he knows how to score. Look at Malik Cook-Stroop. He's been doing a good job defensively. He drew the task of guarding Jeremiah Hill, and he's out of the game now. And back is Marquise Simmons.
Well, pretty good look that time, and Muhammad couldn't get it. Webster got the rebound, and a real advantage with the smaller players behind the bigs there, but couldn't take advantage of it.
Long-range shot by Brandon Roberts. There's Cadet again. He's been valuable to his team since he's been in there. I think that's his fourth rebound, and and put up some points also.
He didn't waste any time to get involved, did he?
No, he's right on it. Yeah, a little push off down low by Justin Simon.
And a timeout at 7:45. 7-point game. More from the GSC here in Birmingham. Looks like our guys lost their banners to the Little Tykes. 29-22. Oh, they're having fun here in the Pete Hanna Center.
Got a good crowd. Got bands rolling. Yeah. And TV coverage is good here. You see a lot of Huntsville stations and Valdosta stations here, too, covering this.
Good fans place to have it.
Yeah, yeah, it's a great, great venue for college basketball. This Sanford Pete Hanna Center is terrific.
Yeah. Sexton open, can't get the three, and once again,
Codette again.
Way up there to get the miss.
Codette's fifth rebound coming off the bench.
Pass deflected from Hill, but it ends up with Simon, and it's just tough for them to stop him.
Well, that's just strong. I'm telling you, whoever you put down there with that strength is going to cause trouble. And he gets knocked down. Webster goes to the basket. He wanted to charge and didn't get it.
And it's a 7-point game. Didn't take long for Webster to see the opening either.
Yeah, it's a little high-low game going there. He ends up down low on Colin Langley at 5'10" from out of Boaz, and that's a true mismatch.
Yeah, he needs stepladder.
Zone on the out-of-bounds by UAH. Good penetration move down the middle.
And a runner that goes in a block.
Well, that's a good move by Josh Lemons just to see that gap in that zone, take it right to the basket.
Making quick decisions in the right one's key.
Well, I'll tell you what, you find those gaps, every zone's got them, and you get players that really take those two steps. That's about all you get against the zones. Two steps inside that with that little soft jumper. Lemons shows why he's a good scorer, too. He's putting them up about 12 a game, and he's having a good game this time, too. He's not only entered in the scoring, but he's also entered in the assist column.
Yeah, he had 17.7 assists last night.
Yeah, good quickness, too. He's guarding Saxton, giving him a lot. They lost to playing a little bit of a sag defense right now on that perimeter play and giving up a couple shots out there. But UAH's not been shooting it very well.
Nope, they're still
that
having trouble.
Codette's got his sixth already in the game. 6 minutes going the first half.
Yeah. Knocked away defensively. Here comes Roberts, and he gets it.
Oh, I can't believe he made that.
Wow.
I saw that with the Globetrotters 1 year when they shot that little shot. That's terrific. Brandon Roberts, great body control. Got fouled pretty hard, too, because the idea is don't let him get it up. You'll see the breakaway here. Codette into him with a body. Ah, man, that's a great finish.
I think you fouled him hard to make sure he didn't make it.
You know, from a coach's standpoint, I'm going to say something about Webster there, too. Webster was under the basket when that turnover happened. He's the guy that would have got the rebound for UAH going the other way, if you notice him coming into the picture.
Yep.
That's sheer hustle, and that's a guy wanting to make sure that UAH makes some noise in this tournament.
7-point game with 6 minutes to go in the half. Hill left his feet, and that created a problem.
Yeah, a bad pass, too. When he got up in the air, he didn't have anything to do with it at his ankles. Big guys can't catch passes at their ankles.
There's a three. Gilmore knocks it down, and now Mike Helfer wants a timeout. He doesn't want that to begin.
Well, the transition game's kind of turned around. UAH now getting out on the run and going. They were losing the battle of fast break points, down 11-3 at the last break. Now they've evened that up.
Here's a good look at it again.
Nice shot by the guy that Coach Acuff says needs to be the defensive player of the year in the conference. He's 44% from the three-point line also, and he showed why right there. He doesn't take a lot of them.
Right.
But the ones he takes are good shot selection, and he's able to knock them down. That was a big shot. That got him from a 7-point deficit down to a 4 and back into this ballgame with 5:46 to go. And now they're looking for a couple of turnovers, and what that Coach Acuff is probably telling them in that timeout is we need a stop. If we can get a stop right here and keep this momentum. So we'll look for a little bit more pressure on the perimeter players.
4-point game, yep.
They changed to a 1-2-2 zone to try to offset that a little bit. So now you got to come down and readjust if you're Valdosta.
And they're just now recognizing it. Hill, that's a tough pass in the corner. Codette can't get it. And out of bounds to Alabama Huntsville.
And UAH gets what they want out of it. I mean, they got a missed shot, which, you know, the change of defense every time, something I've always believed in, too, causes all your team. Everybody's got a different offense against the zone. They do a man-to-man.
Yep.
So you got to change your whole thought pattern coming out of that timeout. Good coaching move, I believe, by Lenny Acuff.
4-point lead for Valdosta State. Webster. Now Ward has it blocked by guess who? Codette. And you're right, they're letting them play physical,
yeah,
Bill.
They are.
Run out turnover. The other way. Yep.
Oh, man, Saxton makes a great finish. I'm telling you, that's two great finishes by UAH. Brandon Robbins the first time. Here comes Saxton on the steal. Takes to the basket. Another hard foul and a great score out of it.
Yeah, Saxton, the redshirt senior. And here's
that's Big Ward going to the basket. Codette with a block, a little bumping, a little elbowing down the floor, getting healed out of the rhythm a little bit. Saxton makes a play. We got a one-pointer.
Just like that.
Yep.
34-33. This is for the championship in the Gulf South Conference. Both of these teams, and probably Delta State, will all be in the tournament, but they all want the hardware and the automatic bid.
There's that back end.
Great job defensively
good job
that
by
time,
Webster,
huh?
and a great rebound on the play, too.
Good block by... That was Lemons. And I tell you what, I think somebody's going to have a blowout in their sneakers the way they're moving.
I think the officials are going to get together and probably watch the physicality of the game a little bit. They're banging. They're trying to stop the fast break with a physical banging up and down the floor. That's what happened that time. We see Justice going to free throw line. Hey, look, he's 84% there. He's played just about the whole way, though, so a little fatigue might be around. He's a good free throw shooter, and you'll see why right here. Concentration, system, and release. I don't believe he hit the rim that time. He's a good shooter.
Yeah, 83%. And you know, you talked about the physicality. That's one of the things they were cleaning up a little bit this year.
Yeah.
So it's different than what they're used to.
You know, they have meetings about physicality all the time, but when you get to going up and down the floor all the time, you could end the game or disrupt the game with too many fouls. So there's a fine line between that. But the game is more physical than it should be, in my opinion.
Yep. A lot of people think it takes away from it, but, you know, it's all your personal preference, too.
Yeah. Well, it's basketball. I mean, that's the thing. It's a game of finesse and skill, I think, and There's got to be some physical play as Webster takes another and just knocks the bottom out of it. He's got good range.
He does.
And all of a sudden, we got a tie game with 3:40. It's been a battle.
Just like that.
And I think a lot of this goes to the defensive effort that Elliott has done from UAH and Gilmore on Hill.
Now let's see if Codette, he can't get it to go. And Saxton brings it across. And Webster, they're going to get the hands foul away from the hoop.
Yeah, Webster didn't like the hard foul that time. It was kind of an arm pull. That's 7 rebounds for Webster.
Yep. 3:16 remaining first half. 36 all between BSU and Alabama Huntsville. Nothing but the bottom of the sack for Webster.
We believe when you study hard, you need to play even harder. Bring your A game, rock the weekend. Climb your way to the top and find your inner champion. World-class faculty and coaches, plus access to over 100 majors, continue our winning traditions. At VSU, you get off the bench and in the game to succeed. Discover Valdosta State University, a hidden gem in higher education.
If I lose, I'll respond with respect.
If I win, I'll back it up with humility.
If I fail, I'll rise up with honor. It's tough for us to put it all on the line.
Don't undo my hard work with poor sportsmanship.
Respect. It's the name of the game.
Hat maker Vincent Brimble prospered in the town of Haddington. Never flashy, he only made the classic bowler. Then suddenly the day's trend became preposterously tall. His Raymond James financial advisor reminded him that focusing on the long term is always fashionable. The fad was indeed a passing one. His patience paid off, allowing him to one day hang up his hat with confidence. Life well planned. See what a Raymond James advisor can do for you.
Well, the sombreros are out now.
I love this crowd. I'm telling you, look at the sunglasses. I guess the lights are too bright in here if you're sitting up in the stand.
And if those are your children, if you're watching at home, and they're studying engineering, they just need a little break from it, right,
they're,
Bill?
They're doing fine.
They're blowing off some steam.
They'll go study tonight, I'll bet you.
And a chance for Alabama Huntsville to take the lead. And that might be their first lead of the game.
I believe it is. I believe it is, and they've done it by good control defense and rebounding on the defensive end, and then good shot selection down here too. And good couple of fast break opportunities too, where Saxton and Brandon Roberts put that ball up under pressure and made the 3-point play. Still ain't got Hill involved like I know they want him to. Here again, I just don't take away from there. Well, I say that, look at here. We got that little screen away from the ball, and he's got such elevation. He is up high for that little off pass. Give credit to the passer. He put the ball right up there where he had to have it.
Yeah, he did.
Nice dunk out, and good play, Coach Heffler out of. He didn't get to be coach of the year for nothing.
No. There's Brandon Roberts for the Chargers. Back and forth now we go.
We may see a ton of lead changes before this one's over.
Hill with 7 points. That's way below his average. But he's very unselfish, as you said, Bill.
Yeah, he is. He's giving that ball up. He knows he's getting defensive pressure. Somebody may be open. He's doing a good job of sharing the basketball. Nice shot by Elliott out of the corner.
Boy, I tell you, it's a game of emotions, isn't it, Coach?
Well, it's a game of runs, too. You're right, boy. Emotions. When momentum jumps up and runs to the other bench, he'll stay there for a while.
Hill can't get it to go. And it'll be Alabama Huntsville ball.
That's a good poster. That's the kick out that... give Saxton that free shot all the time. Good out. outlet pass by Webster, knowing that he's kind of jammed up down low. Gets the ball to Saxon, who is a good shooter from there.
He is. You know, almost all any players are redshirted because they need that year to learn their system, don't they?
That's not a bad idea across the board. I don't know. We used to have freshmen in eligibility.
Same me when I played.
And it wasn't a bad thing either, to
you. You grew up in that year, didn't you?
That first year is so tough academically and making your own decisions away from home. It's not a bad idea. Hill on the corner, boy. That's his shot. He's just a little off so far.
We're going up and down, but nobody hitting right now. Let's see if Webster can change that.
Well, he can shoot. I'm telling you, he's having a first half, that's for sure. I think that's 15.
And Alabama Huntsville, I think they have half the city here.
They do. They got that whole section behind the bench. And, you know, I tell you what, that's big as a player, too, makes those periods of time in the game where you're a little tired.
Whoa, get a little chippy here.
Hill's being guarded hard. There's no question about that. He got fouled, and then hands on.
Yep, and then he responded.
Yeah, little tough. You got to handle this, though. It's a big game. Look at Webster. Nice high arcing shot. He's about 45 transition. They always call for 45 arc on that shot, and he's got it and celebrates it, and he ought to. I think that's 18 for him at this point in the first half.
And they're going to have to go look at the monitor, Bill, because a little jousting after the call.
Well, it was. I mean, you don't want to get that out of hand. You want to guard him tough. He's the best player on the other team. You want to guard him tough, but there's limits as to what you can do. You don't want to do anything above the head. That'll get you a flagrant and get out of here. Play him hard, but, you know, you got to play within the rules. They're going to check to make sure that's what's going on.
Yeah, they're going to discuss it. And they're going to bring him back out.
I think they've just called it a common foul, but that's okay, too.
Yep, that's right.
And Elliott, you got to give him credit, too. 6'2 kid from Bremen, Alabama, down at Cold Springs. He's given all he's got. He knows he's got a challenge with Hill, and he's doing all he can do to keep the ball out of his hands, and that's part of it also.
Yep. Good piece of officiating there, too. Just trying to settle it down.
Yeah, big
sort
game.
It out.
Yeah, officials know it's a big game also. Both teams are doing the best they can do up and down the floor.
Hill knocks down the free throw. That's 8 points for Hill now.
77% from the free throw line. Got some nice shoes, too, by the way.
Yes, he does.
Colorful shoes.
We can find them in the dark.
Yeah,
that's for
bounce
sure.
that around. That's right. Bounce those around. I bet he can shoot in the dark, tell you the truth.
He can. Maybe that's why I got him.
Yeah, it could be. He light up the gym by himself.
46-40, Alabama Huntsville. With the 6-point lead, dribble drive, reverse, doesn't go for Roberts. And Valdosta State trying to look for something here to get a strong finish to the half.
Well, they hit that gap again. You hit that gap sometimes between two players. Valdosta's really good at taking that ball straight to the basket when that happens. And one of the kids has played a real good game for them, Lemons, up to this point. Been pretty solid the whole way.
Yep.
Giving them good points, and now it goes to the line. 78% free throw shooter and knocks them down. He heel over talking to the official, trying to let him know what's going on when he's not looking at him.
And he knocked them both in. And the Huntsville lead is 4. Half minute to go in the first half.
They're not going to have any problem with them getting to their point average so far. We're looking at 46-42. My best math, that's about 92 and 84. And I think that's where Valdosta wants to score up in the 90s. Right now, that's where UAH may get it. See a little zone action by Valdosta coming on the last shot. A little 1-2-2.
And
the guy they didn't expect to take it outside, Justin Moore, goes up.
And he missed it. Hill from half court.
Oh
man.
That might have been
close. That might have had a chance, but his teammate. We're at halftime. A good one. Alabama Huntsville 46, BSU 42. Our halftime show coming straight at you.
Welcome back to halftime here at the Pete Hanna Center in the 2017 GSC Basketball Championships. We want to thank Florida Space Coast for their support throughout the course of the season. It's located near the Melbourne, Florida area, and there's a lot of things to do.
Institutions, 17 sports, 50 national championships, thousands of lives changed. For nearly 50 years, the Gulf South Conference has been a leader in the NCAA. In the GSC, that means compete, graduate, impact. Learn more about the Gulf South at gscsports.org.
We are explorers, pioneers, leaders. We are makers, visionaries, problem solvers. We are passionate, transformative. We are chargers. Expand your horizons at UAH.
Here, we believe when you study hard, you need to play even harder. Bring your A game, rock the weekend. Climb your way to the top and find your inner champion. World-class faculty and coaches, plus access to over 100 majors, continue our winning traditions. At VSU, you get off the bench and in the game to succeed. Discover Valdosta State University, a hidden gem in higher education.
Welcome back to halftime of the GSC Basketball Championships. The student athletes are involved in many ways. Let's take a look at the Student Athletic Advisory Committee.
SAC has been the greatest thing for me. I absolutely love representing SAC at Lee. And for the GSC.
I love getting to represent our school, UWA, and I love getting to represent our conference. I think it's a really cool thing to get to be able to do. You know, not everyone gets to do these kind of things in these leadership positions. So, I take it day by day, and I love getting to work with Michael and Matt and all that. And I love getting to meet all the different representatives from the different schools.
It's so important to recruit the right guys of high character and who are about all the right things, as opposed to maybe the highest talent guys or the best athletes, and that's something that he's been very intentional about.
For me to represent the GSC and Mississippi College is a huge deal. It's an honor to be able to say I play tennis at Mississippi College and we're in the Gulf South Conference. Like, I hold that very close, and I think that it's a great honor.
The thing I'll take away from, you know, my school and my city, playing for my city, it's just pride and honor, and I really learned what hard work is once I reached college and going through school and playing football at the same time.
The reward is so much greater than the work that you put in, like all the workouts, the running, the sprints. Like, when you're on the court and it's a tight match and then you come out with the victory, it's all worth it.
But as you get into college, you're getting into really difficult classes, and swimming at the highest level there is, it's so difficult, but in the end, it's extremely rewarding. And even though you have to make all those sacrifices, it's so worth it because it's such an incredible thing you're able to be a part of.
It really is just a really meaningful experience to get to lead our SAC at Lee. And just know that we have a voice for all student athletes, and we are a connection with our student body.
Create that traditional campus feel and improving the quality of student life to try to give it that more traditional college feel, and to try to really make it an enjoyable experience for all those involved, whether that be new buildings or new programs, new student organizations, and just kind of to witness the growth that's happened. Even in my short time, there's been something really exciting to be a part of.
Favorite thing about the team at West Alabama is definitely personalities. We've got a wide variety of cultures and countries.
I'm trying to pursue a mass media degree, and I want to be a sports video editor. And later on in life, I want to pursue being a photographer for Getty Images.
And welcome back to the Pete Hanna Center. At halftime, a good one going on. Alabama Huntsville 46 and Valdosta State 42. Glad to have you back with us, along with Coach Bill Jones. It's been a pleasure to work with him. I'm simply Don Russell. And Coach, you talked about the first half. I'm going to take a look at some highlights in just a minute. But it was really a very exciting and physical first half, too.
Well, you know, it's 20 minutes, but first 10 minutes was all Valdosta. I mean, right. We look up the score one time, they're just about double digits. And then all of a sudden, UEH decided we need to get our transition game going. They turned that part of it around.
Let's take a look at the highlights.
The transition went to them in the second half. Real tough physical first half. You got to give Steve Webster a lot of credit. He ends up that first half with 18 points and 7 boards. And then you turn to the other side, we got the player we highlighted, Jeremy Hill. He has a quiet 9 points. I mean, he didn't shoot the ball extremely well. There you see Webster, big, strong, 24-6-6. He does a lot of things. Here's one of them he does well. He shoots that 3. Kip Owens gives him a good screen. He pops off of it. Good shot from the corner. We got some good, terrific outside shooters. That's a guy, Cadet, came off the bench for him and gave him a real pickup off the bench as a 6-man hard foul. Brandon Roberts with a terrific finish. Get the ball up on the basket, guys, when you go. Don't just toss it up there. Good outside shot also by Michael Gilmore, who's doing a good job defensively on the hill. Webster again. You just can't give him that shot at the head of the circle. He's too tough. There he is again. Had a great first half. Listen, he'll have a great second half, too, if you give him that wide open shot. He'll finally convert on that nice play called out of the timeout by Coach Heffler. And we've had a terrific first half, I'm telling you. Up and down basketball, a lot of athletic plays. Good inside play. Valdosta kind of winning the inside game a little bit for a long time. Points in the paint is one of their strength, has been all year. All you have to do is look at their two guys down low, and you can see where strength in the paint, points in the paint is a big advantage for them. We'll see Kip Owens come back. If I'm Coach Acuff, what I'll do is I'll set a play for Webster and I'll set one for Hill on the other end.
Yep, we'll take a quick break, have the second half tip-off for the championship of the Gulf South Conference.
Zach has been the greatest thing for me. I absolutely love representing Zach at Lee. And for the GSC.
I love getting to represent our school, UWA, and I love getting to represent our conference. I think it's a really cool, you know, thing to get to be able to do. You know, not everyone gets to do these kind of things in these leadership positions. So, you know, I take it day by day, and I love getting to work with, Michael and Matt and all that, and I love getting to meet all the different representatives from the different schools.
It's so important to recruit the right guys of high character and who are about all the right things, as opposed to maybe the highest talent guys or the best athletes. And that's something that he's been very intentional about.
A beautiful shot of the Pete Hanna Center here on the campus of Samford University, ready for the beginning of the second half. Lenny Acuff's team leads it 46-42, and we should have a barn burner here minutes.
UAH comes out in a 1-2-2 zone. If I'm Coach Heffler, I'm trying to get Hill in the ball game right here. I want to run something where I can get him a little isolated. They go to a points in the paint opportunity down low for Muhammad. Muhammad's going to go to the free throw line. 67% wasn't his strength in the first half, though.
That's right.
Got a little shake and quiver there to him when he goes to the line.
There's a two players that we saw that last night, and I thought maybe he had a coach him.
Yeah. Well, you want a system when you go there. That's the key. Do the same thing every time. Get confidence in it. Make it work. There it is. That's the little shake. We'll see how that turns out on the second one. You know, no, not good. Maybe he started to shake wrong from the wrong shoulder, maybe.
Maybe the girls like it.
Yeah, maybe so.
Don't ask us to do it. That's all.
No, I'd pull something if I did that.
Oh, look at that second effort.
That's a good second shot opportunity. Yeah, he's rang up 20 already. You know, that's the point. You get Webster now. You got the Kip Owens back in the game, which gives them some height around the basket. Kip can give them something from the outside, too. And here's Webster back at the free throw line, draining another one. And now he gets a little penetration on that baseline. Great second shot opportunity.
21 for Webster. And he has 8 rebounds as well.
UAH transitioning back to a man-to-man now, kind of keeping things up. Looks like maybe a little bit of a matchup. Kip Owens hanging around the middle.
That's
nice shot. Bo Justice having a great game, isn't he?
He buried that one as soon as he saw the opening.
Yeah, came transfer out of West Liberty State up in Ohio, Peebles, Ohio. I don't think I've ever heard of Peebles. That's where Bo Justice is from. Kip Owens working that high screen. 4 out perimeter. Brandon John. Good steal by Bo Justice on the outlet pass.
And he's going full speed over Owens. Owens had to kind of back off or did. Yeah. And he took advantage of it.
Yeah, sitting on that bench the whole first half with fouls causes you to do that right there. Normally in that circumstance, he tried to get a block. Give credit to Justice. That's a big basket.
Saxton deep in the corner. Nice little head fake. And a beautiful jump shot by Gilmore. The head fake got it for him, didn't it?
Yeah, it did. Put him up in range. Got his feet off the floor. A little penetration, 2 dribble. Make that 15-foot jumper. Don't take it all the way to the basket. You're not big enough to go in there. He shoots a little jumper.
And how about the same thing at the other end?
He decided to come out of the locker room this time.
Yes, he did. And he's trying to get after the defense on Saxton.
A little out of sync on the play that time. A good reset by Brandon Roberts.
There's Webster against his opposite number, 24. And that's their bread and butter. That's what they want to do because he can go both ways.
Well, he can. He's got the power to go low. That's the thing. You got to have strength when you go against Valdosta's 2 big guys down low to get the ball up and get it to the basket. He did. He got fouled on the play, but this is not a weakness right here for C. Webster. When he goes to the line, a lot of times big guys, you go ahead and foul them when you get down there because you know they can't shoot if you got enough fouls to waste. And they do because they got Cadet that came off the bench a while ago, good for him.
And but, you know, when he got in foul trouble yesterday, he was just so anxious over on the bench because he couldn't do anything to help.
Well, he's an intense player. He's been that way really ever since he was at Madison County High School up in Gurley. He's a player. Played for his dad, so what do you expect?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, his dad's probably pounded him on the way back and forth the gym.
Yeah.
All these players used to say to me, you know, the thing I hated worst about playing with my dad there was the ride home.
Great point. Perfect opportunity on the follow-up by Beverly. He'll go to the line. And Webster, though, has picked up his 3rd foul.
Yep. Well, he's not a guy right there right now that they can lose.
Yep.
He's just got to settle down a little bit. Try to play without fouling. Beverly goes to the line. Not a good free throw shooter. Probably the worst on the team at 37%. But it's a big game, and players shoot better in big games when he balances that percentage out with a miss.
That was a little flat, wasn't it?
Tried to get the guy down here to let me wear that sombrero the rest of the hype, but he wouldn't do it. Wouldn't give it up. He said it was his lucky hat.
Yeah. We could have put some tortilla chips in that one.
Yeah, look at Webster. Woo! He's having a game, I'm telling you. He's having a game. If I'm not mistaken, that's 24 for him.
He's the big enchilada.
Yeah, he is. He could wear the sombrero.
He could.
I know the guy would give it to him.
No question.
Justice, he's feeling it. That shot just down, halfway down, and it comes out. But he's feeling it the second half. He's trying to take over. Hill's been a little quiet already in the start of the second half.
Let's see if they can get it inside to Owen, too.
Nice.
How about
pass.
That?
Good pass.
Right on cue.
Penetrate that ball to the basket and give it up. Nice play.
Same thing at the other.
Well, you talk about a good call play now. Heffler calls that play. He wants to get down on Webster because he's got his 3rd, get his 4th. Went right to him, and he got out of the way. Webster gave it up to him. You'll see that probably again.
And Owens will go to the line.
Kip Owens had to sit most of the first half trying to make himself known here. In the start of the second half, goes to the free throw line. Kind of a little offset shot, but hey, it goes in. He's 91% from the line, and look at the shot. It'll go to his left side of his face. I don't like the look of the shot, but I love the result.
That's all that matters, yeah. Isn't it? You know, that he's a big guy that can run the floor,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, very agile for a 6'9".
Yes, he is. 60-52, Alabama Huntsville. It was Valdosta State and a steal by Roberts, but it's going to be a foul.
Yeah, Gilmore causing all kind of trouble for Hill.
Yep.
He's got quick hands and quick feet himself, and that penetration drive, he's causing a lot of trouble for Hill. Hill's getting a little frustrated, too. You can tell that.
Yep, that's his. Gilmore, a little inside shot. Nope. Good rebound.
Look at that offensive rebound. I'm telling you. Muhammad got off the floor. And good rebounders always do just what he did. They anticipate where that ball's coming off, and they get to that point.
This one didn't get any of it. On by Brandon Roberts. 15:44 remaining to see who will take home the GSC tournament title. Got a good one going on. We'll be right back.
GSC TV on ESPN3 is brought to you by Florida Space Coast, Orlando's closest beaches. By the Gulf South Conference, compete, impact, graduate. By Raymond James, official financial planner of the Gulf South Conference, and by Never Thirst, life flows.
And the Pete Hanna Center, our backdrop for the GSC Men's Basketball Championship. Right now, it's the 2-seed Alabama Huntsville leading over Mike Helfer's top-seeded Valdosta State Blazers. Still a lot of time to go.
UAH pops it back out, and it looked like kind of a little matchup 2-3 zone. Down low, try to get the ball down and low against Wefter. That's what they want to do, see if they can get his fourth. He has been tough in this ballgame. They want him out. Over the back, Kip Owens with a good box out on that weak side, and that's the value of him coming off that bench. He gives that limp, good position player, good agile player, good box out on Muhammad. Gets the foul call. 6-point lead. UAH needs a good play run right here. I'll be surprised if it doesn't go through Webster's hands in some fashion. 2-3 zone by Valdosta to offset things. Don't put it on the floor in there, big guy. You're too tall.
Yep. Running jumper at the other end by Valdosta State, and Webster gets the rebound.
Had the shot. It might have been a little too quick for most teams, but not for Valdosta. That's the shot they live and die on.
Yes, it is.
Stayed in the zone in that position because they got a turnover, no reason to get out of it. Still a little bit more control, I think, by UAH this time, though.
Good bounce pass.
Ho, ho, where'd he come
Webster
from?
Webster! Ho!
came out of the rafters all the way down the bleachers all the way to the floor. Caught that ball in the air and dunked it. Nice play by Wifta. He came to play today, fellas. If you're following U88, you're proud of him today so far.
Yep, 62-54.
Justice with a good pass. Post player wasn't ready. If you drive the baseline, that post player's setting up in the middle. He's got to be ready for it.
Webster didn't get it, and nobody there to get the rebound but Muhammad.
He'd hit that three from there. He could have been elected mayor in Huntsville next election.
That's exactly right. Here's Hill, the little step back, and bounces it over the front of the rim.
Yeah, I know. They're ready to get him cranked up.
Right.
He's got so much talent. He's so quick on that outside. If he gets hot like Webster's been hot, we'll have a burner to the end.
Yep. 11 in the game now for Hill. This three in and out.
By Webster. Halfway down, not a bad shot. I mean, that's the guy you want shooting. He's hot. Let him shoot 2-3 zone. You get that shot in the corner off a little screen down low, and your guy that's been hot for you all night gets the shot. Hill wants a little isolation on the other side. There's the down screen. I don't know what happened here.
I think Owens has picked up his
hold.
Foul. Yep.
Hold, I guess, on Owens. Yeah, we're going to see Webster right now. Where'd he come from? There's the shot, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, boom, the big guy comes to the basket with some authority and a little physicality on the end, just to let him know I was down there. Nice play.
Yep, and Kip Owens goes to the bench now with three fouls. So that height is gone now.
Yeah, that'll change things around the basket. You look right now, you'll see some offensive rebound probably by Valdosta and some post-up play down low.
Here's Hill. Starts in, backs it out, and has to regain his balance. And boy.
Well, that's a great defensive effort by Gilmore. All that contact was in the middle of his body. I mean, that's nearly a charge, if you want to call it that. You got to give credit where credit's due defensively. He was tough on that series.
Elliott with the floater.
Elliott with the floater. Now we've already jumped up to an 8-point lead. It might be about timeout for Coach Heffler here. He's talking to the official about the play on Hill. But if you look at that score and that clock, you don't want to get UAH on too big a roll right here. They don't get a score right here, they'll be looking for one. And boom, all of a sudden, Damian Young has been kind of quiet the whole game. A senior out of Atlanta, Mississippi Valley State transfer, comes in and knocks down a big three.
64-59. Three ball, other end. Nope. Too strong on the shot by Ward. And VSU.
Goodness.
Long three.
I'm not sure that's what he wanted.
No, I don't think so either.
Just because you hit one doesn't mean you hit two from further out.
Yeah, it's not contagious.
No, it's not something that gives you a guarantee.
Yep. Hey, Elliott comes guarantee. Back.
That's a nice two shots by Chase Elliott. He's giving a little pump lift here off the bench. Cold Springs has always had good shooters. Tristan Chambers, it goes to Sanford here from Cold Springs. These two guys played together in high school. Look at here. They can both shoot the rock.
Boy, they can. Hill being checked by Gilmore. Hill shoots in and out. Rebound to Webster. Saxton brings it up.
UAH on the run. Webster with a quick jumper from the head of the circle. He's had three good shots lately and hadn't knocked any of them down.
Yep. Good rebound by Beverly.
But Justice takes it, and we're going to try to turn a little offense here. Need a shot for Valdosta State. I mean, they're down eight now. They need a basket. Down low where their strength is. And sure enough, that turn by Simon produces a basket. Big, strong post player. Hadn't gotten the basketball in about the last five trips down the floor on the inside. They get it, and they get a basket. Something to learn from that.
We have five subs waiting to get in. Owens will come back in after that easy hoop inside by Valdosta State.
Valdosta stays with that matchup zone a little bit. It's a 1-2-2. It has some flex to it.
Elliott can't get this one to go.
Trying to shoot over the big guy down low. Couldn't get it up.
Justice. And Simon going to try to back his way in on Webster and gets the basket.
That's four.
And the foul.
That four on him?
Yep. That is four. A timeout on the floor. 67-63. The big guy inside. Simon puts it in. Back to the Phoenix. Four-point game, Bill, and with 10:04 to go, going to have the strategy here, and you see Webster over there on the bench, and if you're Lenny Acup, that's not where you want him.
Well, here's the problem. The problem is your guy's got 28 points and been hot all game, is now over there beside you drinking Powerade, and now you got to decide what point put him back in. You hope that what you do now is you get Brandon Roberts, who is their second lead scorer, and the guy that's sitting with eight right now, you get him involved. The zone has been pretty good for Valdosta State. Has controlled the fast break points. They're rebounding well out of it. And so far, UAH has not hit the big outside shot.
Oh, a fortuitous bounce.
Maybe Owens is going to take over that role. That's a long-range shot.
Yeah, he can shoot from long range.
Kip at 43% from the outside. I mean, you want him up that post, handling everything, seeing over everybody on that zone and knocking it down. And there it is. Bounce, bounce. Everybody in the gym will say that's a shooter's touch right there.
Yep.
Hit that rim with that good backspin and that good arc, and all of a sudden it'll bounce around and find a hole. Two basketballs will go in that rim side by side, so put it up there, Kip, and see what happens.
9.5 to go. Valdosta State's women have already punched their ticket on the women's side in the Gulf South Conference. Elliott had it stripped away. A two-person game, Justice, and it's blocked, but it's going to be a foul.
Yeah, foul on Justin Morgan. And not a bad foul because he's going to the basket. He's obviously going to score. Let's put him to the line and see if he can convert there. And so far, Bo Justice has been converting there. He's had a really nice game. 84% from the free throw line. Good tough kid. Done a lot of good things. A lot of good passes made in the ball game. Knocks down the first one.
Get all your GSC news, stats, and championship information at gscsports.org, the official internet home of the Gulf South Conference. 70-65, 9 minutes left.
UAH really needs Brandon Roberts to get involved in the offense and pick this thing up a little bit. He's perimeter player, got a turnover on a pass on the basket. Here comes Hill.
Hill with 11 points. but he's 4 for 11, 1 of 6 on threes today.
Yeah, he's not had his average night so far, but with 8 minutes to go, you look for champions to step up in championships, so we may see him yet. Good, strong inside basket.
Yeah, and
that's
again,
where Webster gave him that strength down
right.
low.
Muhammad gets the hoop.
Muhammad, a big, tough kid down there, too, averaging about 13 points a game. He goes down and converts.
3-point lead for Alabama Huntsville.
Staying in the zone. Owens down low.
Deep corner. 3-ball. Justin Ward.
Justin Ward could give him a lift right here if he starts hitting that outside shot. Good penetration that time. From the weak side, finds the shooter in the corner, produces points. UAH needed that, goes back up by 6. Here's that ball down low again, though. Here's the matchup that they're yep. begging for, and they get it again.
Yep, Muhammad.
Gonna have to make a change somehow. He's gonna have to switch people. I think what we've got is a
TV timeout. 73-69, 7:41 remaining. We'll be back.
Twelve institutions, 17 sports, 50 national championships, thousands of lives changed. For nearly 50 years, the Gulf South Conference has been a leader in the NCAA. In the GSC, that means compete, graduate, impact. Learn more about the Gulf South at gscsports.org.
You develop a personal relationship with administrators, with advisors, with counselors, with teachers.
I'm a digital media major with a cinema emphasis, so ultimately I hope to direct film and just make movies that make people think and that inspire them and, you know, kind of like stand the test of time.
And then I actually want to go into doing research to make nuclear energy more efficient, because I really feel like we're one big break in nuclear energy away from, you know, solving all the energy problems in the world.
Let's go!
Webster, they have him back on the floor, Bill. 28 points for Webster, and you got to have him out in this situation, and he comes in with 7:41 remaining.
Well, I see the ball for Valdosta will go low, I think, every time now, because
yep. They'll try to get him out, won't
they? Yeah, with him back in the game. Of course, Cadet came in the game. Cadet's not a real post-up player. He came in the ball game for Simon, and may give him a little relief down there.
Zone here, play a little zone. And there they go, might have got away with a travel, but he got the hoop.
That toughness is what they need with that big, strong post up down low. He yep. is just hard to manage down there. They needed to stretch this thing out a little bit. If they do, they'll give him another break, see if they can keep the fouls away. But here he goes inside. I'm yep. telling you, that's just a hard match right there. Muhammad is going down low on Ward and just backing him under the basket.
And not much you can do about
and
it either.
Finish it. No. Yep. I mean, you know, you got to have the strength to hold him out of there. But he's a big, strong kid.
Saxton. Long three by Roberts off the back of the iron. Hill with the rebound and brings it up.
Well, they needed that shot to go down just to give him some confidence out there. Cadet outside. That'll ease the pressure on Webster a little bit, guarding an outside guy like that if Cadet stays out there. I think Coach Acuff wanted that matchup. He saw that exchange and Cadet coming back in. If they go back to two strong posts, it may take Webster back out.
There's the penetration and a foul. As going to the hoop, Brandon Roberts.
Brandon Roberts, kind of like Hill. I mean, he comes into the game averaging just under 17 points a game. He's sitting there with seven. Got a chance to go to nine, and it's been a kind of a quiet nine. It hadn't been one of those things. Like, if that three goes in, the sombreros go up and everybody's happy. But right now he's at the line. Got his arc is a little too high. You know, it's been proven that the high arc that he just shoots produces less points than the one that's flat and straight. So you want a 45-degree arc on that ball. His is about 60. And so if it hits that rim, it's gone. It's got to go straight down the middle, which that one does. Then you get a, and it looks like a good shot, but percentage-wise, you want that thing a little bit lower for all you kids out there. You want to try to develop a 45-degree arc on that free throw shot.
And they have machines now that actually measure it.
Absolutely, they do, and that's a guy in Alabama that invented that.
It sure is. There's the basket inside.
Well, that's Josh Lemons, and he's a player kind of like Roberts in this ball game. He's been a little quiet, except he's made terrific plays when he's had the opportunity to do it. He comes into this free throw with a really good free throw percentage. He's got eight, now he's got 10, now he's got 11. He's in double figures, and that's one of the strengths of Valdosta's team is they usually put five guys or four guys at least in double figures, well balanced.
2-point game, under six to go. Alabama Huntsville with the possession.
Playing a little four out, one in. Webster goes to the corner, and goodness, I'm telling you, whatever he ate as a pregame meal, they need to give it to him every time.
He has 33. He's hit 5 out of 10 threes. 79-74.
Well, he's back down low. The switch, for some reason, he's down low. They got the two posts back in the game. That's why he's back down low, guarding Muhammad. And Muhammad gives him a break, except he scores. He gives him a break by shooting a fall-away jumper.
I think he surprised a little bit of everyone banking that one in.
Yeah, he's having a good game himself.
79-76.
Well, we talked before the game about being a plethora of athletes out here. You can see the scoring's balanced by both teams. Throwaway pass by Ward on a penetration, trying to kick it out. So many blue shirts in the fan in the stands, he might have thrown that to a spectator.
Yep. By the way, Webster's career high is 38. He has 33 right now.
Closing in with 5 minutes to go. I'm sure he'd love to break that if he can get a 1-point win in this game. That's a hold on Ward down low, but he's kind of overmatched down there with Muhammad. Muhammad gives him a lot of trouble. He shot the little short range jumper a while ago. They switched off, and Webster went back and took Beverly that just came in. That puts Ward back on Muhammad.
And the shimmy didn't work, but he got his own miss.
I'm telling you, you got to be upset if you're Coach Acuff. I used to run a team hard as I could run them on. Not being able to rebound 4-on-2 under the free throw.
Should happen, shouldn't it?
Yeah, it shouldn't happen. Statistically, that shouldn't happen because you got them outnumbered, but sometimes it does. But they catch a break and doesn't go down. 3-point ball game with 4:22.
Yep, here's Ward. Takes it on the right wing now. Sexton. Down it goes to Webster where they want it to go. Trying to back his way in. A lot of contact. Knocked away, but he was able to pick it back up. 5 to shoot. Saxton lets it go and hits it.
Big shot. And you know what? That's the first time either one of us has said shot clock.
Yeah. And you're right. They could have saved the electricity.
That's right. And he still had 5 seconds.
Yeah. 82-76. Inside it goes. We're going to have a travel. And that'll take us to the under four timeout with 3:44 remaining. They're on their feet, the fans from Huntsville. Talk about the big shot, Saxton, money. We'll be right back.
Hey.
Yeah, he was a four-point student at Trinity High School in Louisville, which, you know, it's not easy to do.
Is that right?
Yeah. .82-76, 3:42 remaining. Here's Webster in the corner, three ball, too strong. Kip off Owens. Gilmore, and Owens gets it.
Kip Owens back in the game, set out a while with foul trouble, gets a big offensive board. 3:19 to go, up by six for UAA. That's a big recovery. Had a nice shot in the corner, penetration by Webster, but it couldn't get it to go down. That was Michael Gilmore. Back to a man-to-man for Valdosta State.
Yep.
Saxton down the middle with a great kick out. And production. Chase Elliott from the corner with a big three. Yep. He hammers his fist home. He knows how big that was. That jumped it up to nine.
85-76.
I still say it, even though he hadn't had a great game, I would guard Hill during this possession right here.
Spinning shot, a little bit short, but a foul as Josh Lemons took it inside.
Well, I just about have to agree with Coach Acuff, who told me before the game that he thought Gilmore was one of the better defenders in the league, and he's done a great job. He's helped the lead scorer in the league to 11 up to this point with 2:41 to go, and frustrated him out too, I'll say, in that position where they needed him to come off a screen down low. He's a little bit reluctant to come off that screen, and Lemons has to take it to the basket. Lemons is a good scorer. Valdosta's got six in double figures now. They balanced the scoring out, yep. But they haven't got that guy like UAH has got right now with 33.
And we're going to take a timeout here. It'll be a full break. 2:41 remaining. UAH 85, Valdosta State 78.
.17 sports. 50 national championships. Thousands of lives changed. For nearly 50 years, the Gulf South Conference has been a leader in the NCAA. In the GSC, that means compete, graduate, impact. Learn more about the Gulf South at gscsports.org.
If I lose, I'll respond with respect.
If I win, I'll back it up with humility.
If I fail, I'll rise up with honor. It's tough for us to put it all on the line.
Don't undo my hard work with poor sportsmanship.
Respect. It's the name of the game.
Hatmaker Vincent Brimble prospered in the town of Haddington. Never flashy, he only made the classic bowler. Then suddenly the day's trend became preposterously tall. His Raymond James financial advisor reminded him that focusing on the long term is always fashionable. The fad was indeed a passing one. His patience paid off, allowing him to one day hang up his hat with confidence. Life well planned. See what a Raymond James advisor can do for you.
The Valdosta State fans, a little concerned look on their face.
Yeah, they need a basket, but they don't have the ball right now. This is a big possession for UAH. See Valdosta go to a full press. Pressure on the ball, pressure on the inbounds. Webster comes down to help that out, and you'd expect that. Halftime, he was up in the concession stand selling popcorn. Now he's down, and now a turnover.
Dropped it out of bounds.
Sometimes the press makes you do funny things, and Valdosta goes to it and get a turnover out of it. You see them do that again here in a minute. Big possession right now defensively for UAH and offensively for Valdosta. Go back to the inside. If you can get Webster out of this game right now, it'd be big.
Yep.
Oh, stripped and stolen. Play.
Yep, it was by Gilmore.
That was a good hands play right there by the guy from Center Point High School here in Birmingham, Alabama.
85-78. 2 minutes and change remaining.
Well, you're playing the clock now for your UAH. You got no 5 second count out there. Uh-oh, that's a charge. And a good defensive play by Lemons, too. That's the last thing you want, not getting a shot up with 1:57 to go. But good defensive effort. Give credit to Lemons for a great play. And here it is. You can see he gets that body over position, sees the baseline. You know, contact in the middle of the jersey.
Yep.
Moving a little bit, but that doesn't matter if his contact's good right in the center, and it was.
Yeah, Saxton upset with himself. There's the little jump hook by Simon in the lane.
And a good play by Webster, too. Defensively, could have got his fifth there. He recognized that I want to be in this game when it's over. He didn't foul him.
Double team. And now, you know, UAH wants to use the clock and take care of the basketball.
They do. You got a five-point lead. 1:20 on the clock. You got to run something. You still got up a good shot, though. We got 9 seconds on the shot clock. I say Webster. Screen off of him, guy, nice penetration, but he gets a foul.
Yeah, Elliott was grabbed, and really, they bailed him out.
Yeah, they did.
He was off balance, wasn't he?
He was, and he was going to turn the ball over and got a foul on the arm. He's a good free throw shooter, too, though. Just about everybody on this floor is a good free throw shooter, but he's at 82%, and he's a guy that came from a JUCO. He's a guy that came from Cold Springs where they developed good shooters. I'd expect this shot to be a good one.
And it is. So Elliott gets the first one to go. And he has 15 points. He's been a big factor.
He has really played well, and he's the guy when Gilmore's out that draws Hill, which is a load. They've done a great job on him. You see them both casually walking down the floor, Gilmore and Hill. Hill's looking up at the clock and knows they don't have much time to make this happen.
7-point game, a minute 12. Here comes the long jumper by Hill. Nope. And saved in by UAH.
It's a terrific play by Brandon Roberts on a long rebound. You see fouls starting to happen now. You got to get them at the line if you want to get it back.
Yeah,
you don't have anybody to foul, though.
That's right. Pick your poison.
Yeah, I mean, you don't see. What you got to do is foul the guy generally with the ball. And the guy with the balls are always a good free throw shooter. Saxon strolling to the line, had a really good game himself tonight. 79-80% free throw shooter. He's going up there with 11 points. UAH putting everybody back so they won't get beat in transition. And Saxton rolls it off.
Rare miss. And here we go. Under a minute. Valdosta State needs hoops. And that's going to be a holding foul.
Oh, we call it on Elliott on the box out.
Wow.
That's a tough call.
Yes, it is.
Tough call, but... gives him a chance to cut into that lead. Justin Simon, that's a good shot, fellas. That's a good shot from the truck. Follow that ball to the basket, but I don't know about that. We got the guy that does a shimmy up here at the line. He knocks down a big one. He hadn't shot the ball real well from there this ball game, but now we're down to where it's got to count. Brandon Roberts going out of the game, and Justin Ward for some rebounding strength coming in.
And that one goes.
And the big guy knocks them both down. He's going out now. Defensive effort coming in. Carlos Beverly. Give him that front of that press. And look at the arm span on him. You can see why he's in.
Tried to get a foul in the backcourt, but UAH got it in. We'd like to remind you, the field for the 2017 Division II Championship will be announced tonight at 10:30 p.m. Eastern, 9:30 Central on NCAA.com. Be sure to visit NCAA.com for all your tournament information. That'll all be tonight. A lot of people will be watching.
They will, and I'll be watching. These are two good teams right here who will make an impact. Just a shame to me as Eric puts up the first free throw and knocks it down to give them a six-point lead again with 47 seconds. It's strange to me that in the region, because of money, they'll play each other again,
right,
possibly.
Right.
I don't like that setup at all. I'd like to get out of the region and show some strength against other conferences. That's the way it is.
Hill's long three. He knocks it down in a timeout.
Well.
And we got a three-point game.
He hadn't scored a lot, but he scored big. And now we got
and
a four-point
right
game.
Time.
Yeah, at the right time, 40 seconds to go. That huddle's going to be big right there. Here's the replay of Hill. That's an NBA jump shot three, not a set shot three. He's got good strength in his legs. He gets that thing up. Codette on the bench says, yes, that is a three. And we cut it in to a four-point lead. That's a three-point lead now with that big three.
Well, both teams. What's the thought pattern here, Bill, with 40 seconds to go, 30 on the shot clock?
Press hard if you're Valdosta. Try to get that turnover down here. They talk to the officials. A push off by Webster down there. He's the big guy down on the end that they make him throw it up to. But he pushed off last time to get open down there. I'm sure they talked to the officials about that. A little stagger set by UAH. And if you're at UAH, get it into the guys that have hit free throws. Saxton missed the last one. He's got it. You're going to have to foul him soon.
And they got the steal. Momentarily, it kicked out of bounds by Webster.
He did. That's a big play. Get aggressive. Get aggressive. If you get a turnover, great. If you foul them, that's okay, too, because you got to put them on the line or get a steal. Credit Valdosta's guards. Boy, that play in the middle of the floor, just sheer aggression, and that's Hill going after the ball.
Yep. And now they're going to discuss it, but
they may
I think
go
it was
look
pretty
at
obvious.
It. Yeah, Webster kicked it out of bounds. Thought they might look at it, but they didn't have to. That was pretty obvious.
That was the one thing they couldn't afford to do, right? UAH.
Yeah, you want to go to the free throw line, but you sure don't want to turn it over at half court.
Right.
Well, that's an instant basket. They're lucky they didn't go straight down there and score.
Well, that brings life back to the VSU fans. Tough shot.
That's a good shot.
Oh, and a good shot goes down.
Yeah, you don't have to have three in that situation because you're going to get another possession. He takes it right to the hole. Lemons came up big on that shot. Got it to a one-pointer, 26 seconds.
Yep. Of course, the winner gets the automatic bid. Here's the play for the two.
Yeah, it looked like Coach Acuff thought he had a little travel there. Couldn't see his feet real well, but I do know one thing. He took it to the rack with some authority. Could have drawn the foul, which could have tied this ball game up on that play.
Yep. Well, I mentioned this in the women's game and want to do the same here. Want to congratulate Matt Wilson and thank his whole staff for the great job they've done here since the tournament's been here in Birmingham. And I know you're familiar. You do the Samford games. Beautiful facility for this tournament.
Well, it couldn't be better. It's a central location, I think, for most of the conference. I mean, the travel in and out, the hotels, motels are great. You got a lot of eating places. It's just a great venue for this. Plus, you get some Birmingham fans that are really big basketball fans out here. We got a nice crowd today, very enthusiastic crowd. It's a great place for it. They do a great job setting it up. It's been just nothing but enjoyment for me. I love the Gulf South Conference, and I love coming back here. And now we're down to a wire-chasing game. I've had three overtimes in this building already this year.
Yeah.
And all of them have gone down. This one's going to be just the same. See the big Carlos Beverly on the ball. A lot of pressure on the front. Got to get it in. Got
to
get a timeout.
Take the timeout. Fortunately for Alabama Huntsville, now they have two VSUs out of timeout.
Yeah. Well, and you see some good changes too. You see some people coming in. Took a post player out in Justin Simon there. Took him out and replaced him with Damian Young. Give some quickness to Valdosta's press. Two guards broke off. Best thing you do is send that third guy up there to give an outlet. Damian Young, because of his quickness, goes up there with him. Good substitution pattern there on a really big play by Coach Heffler.
Yep. Well, finally, the VSU fans have something to stand about. They were a little gloomy earlier.
Yeah, 26 seconds, get a steal here. You see Elliott that shot it well back here at half court along with Brandon Roberts. Got all your free throw shooters in now. Comes into Sexton. Going to have to trap him somewhere or get a foul.
There's the reach. Yeah, right there.
Yeah, he can't let that go too long. I mean, whatever he does, if he hits them both here, you still got a chance to tie with a three. Or if he misses one, you got a chance to take it to the rest. Real hard. Sexton goes to the line last time. Had a miss on his first one.
Well, we talked about the three. Like it or don't like it, that's why it's really changed the game at the end.
It's giving them a chance to get back in the ball game with a couple of threes and some strong thing. Now we're going to come up with that major question. If he hits both of these, if you're UH, do you foul or not? I don't like it. A lot of coaches think right here in this situation, you get that clock to run down to about 12 or so, and you foul and put them at the line. We'll just see how Coach Acuff plays that.
Yeah, Saxon has 12. Here's his second try, and he rolls it in.
So that situation exists now, so what do you do?
We'll see.
Let it roll, pick it up.
Here we go.
Three-point game, 20 seconds.
Yep. Justice puts it up and in. A one-point game. 15 seconds remaining.
Oh.
And they nearly turn it over. But Webster saves it. 11 to go. They have to foul now.
Well, I'll tell you, that's a break for UAH. That pass was over his head. Brandon Roberts with a great effort keeping that ball in play. He tosses it up, and who should catch that pass?
Right.
Nobody but Webster. He's had the game of the game, so to speak. Likely that he would catch that ball. Saxon back there again with a chance to make it.
Five out of six
again
at the line.
Coach Heffler decided with 20 seconds we're going to go get the basket and see what happens. And Justice takes it right down the middle of the lane for Valdosta with a big basket on that end. Another big shot for Saxton.
And he makes it.
And another conversion. Timeout. Let's see what we can set here with 10 seconds to go. It's just about automatic. You got to have a three here now.
Yeah.
So Coach Acuff wants to make sure that he's got all the people guarded that can shoot it. And then from Heffler's standpoint, he's going to put five guys in there that can shoot it, because a pass, an interior pass for somebody down low, makes no difference now unless you could draw a foul. But you won't get it, because if it goes in now and you're down there, just let him score.
Of course, both teams in the double bonus. Does it get to a point? Do you foul quick?
Well, here's that question again that came into play when that three-point line came in. Right now, if you're Acuff, you don't really mind a foul if a guy is not outside the three-point line. If he's going to the basket, you just let him go.
Yeah.
Or you can foul somebody and say, let's rebound the free throw line. He's got Kip Owens. The only problem with that with Valdosta is they got big, strong kids.
Yeah,
and right
do.
Now, the officials don't want to side it, so you'll get a lot of pushing and shoving on the basket. So if the guy makes the first one, misses the second one on purpose, and you get it back, that's just a big question mark. Me personally, I want to make him shoot a hard outside three with a hand up.
Well, here's the final 9.8 seconds, possibly. 92-89, Mount Alabama Huntsville. And Valdosta State with the ball. They'll have to bring it the length of the floor.
Well, you got Mohammed in the game that can't shoot a three. Codette came into the game who can shoot a three.
Here's Lemon.
There's the foul.
Yep, and the foul.
And I think that was, I won't say intentional because it wasn't that, but it was a foul to put him at the free throw line as opposed to giving up the three.
So, and it's two shots now.
The rebounders will have to come in now, though, for here they come. Kip Owens and Ward both are coming in to make sure that UAH gets this ball off. Valdosta coming back with their big strength.
Lemons rolls it in.
Well, that was important.
Had orange paint on it.
Well, if he'd have missed that one, he wouldn't have had a chance. Yep. So now they got the chance for a miss. Don't forget it has to hit the rim, though.
Right.
A lot of guys just shoot that up there at the basket. Look for the pushing by Muhammad and Simon down low.
6.2 remaining. Lemons puts it up, and he got it.
And he made it. That was a situation where I thought he might miss it on purpose. They're banking on right now getting a five-second counter, being able to steal the inbounds pass. 6 seconds to go if it takes two to get it in, and they get a free throw on the other end.
Gilmore gets it in to Webster, and he's fouled right away.
Well, that took 2 seconds off the clock, so now if he hits these two, it'd be hard for them to come the length of the floor in 4.5 seconds to get off a good shot, but it's been done before.
Yep.
It's the kind of game that you'd see it happen in, but Webster's got to knock them both down.
He's hit 8 out of 9 at the free throw line, a game high 33 points.
Boy, he's been tough all night.
And now he's 9 out of 10.
And that's calm. That's a very calm shot. See defenders coming back in the game for UAH. Colin Langley, who's coming back in for some quickness at the guard position. They're small now other than Webster, but it doesn't matter because it'll be an outside shot after that shot.
Yep.
Webster. 3 down, 4.5. It's going to be a desperation.
Here we go. Three-pointer on the way.
Oh,
no,
that was close.
Alabama Huntsville has won the Gulf South Conference Men's Basketball Championship. Lenny Acuff and Mike Helfer respect each other's coaching ability, and a happy bunch of Chargers
big
out on
game.
The floor.
Nice game, great game. Last second shot, boy, it was dead on line from behind it. I thought he had it. Great play by Valdosta State to get that shot with 4.5 seconds. Did you see the sombrero dance in the middle?
Yes, sir. Lenny Acuff gets another GSC tournament championship. And there it is for 2017. We'll take a break at the post-game activities. UAH champion of the GSC in men's hoops.